Hello,
this is one of my first videos, so I decided to start creating some content always related to the things that I have been posting. So structural analysis, design of wood buildings, cross laminated timber on one hand, and on the other hand numerical modeling of timber buildings with Codaster. So today I want to talk about the new module that has been integrated in the latest version of Salomeca. So Salomeca is a general analysis environment that contains various modules that help you to perform fine element analysis. It has also the Codaster open source solver. Everything is open source in Salomeca. And in the latest version, there is also a module that is called OpenTurns for reliability and probabilistic analysis. So you can always download from codaster.org Salomeca, the latest version. And you can see in this OpenTurns.org some information about this module that I'm talking about. So I'm going to show a very simple example. This is the interface of Salomeca, and I have here a 3D model of a CLT panel, a 5-layer CLT panel of 140 millimeters, and we're applying some permanent loads, some live loads. We are actually doing just the serviceability limit state analysis, so we are interested in the form, shape, and the displacement at the middle. Is just a single span of a panel with a single span. And so the idea and the question we actually want to ask, to answer, is what would be the displacement and deformation in the middle if I have the material properties that are not deterministically defined anymore, but I have a probabilistic model for these properties. So I'm taking the material properties of wood. As we know, it is wood is an orthotropic material. So, and the most two important moduli for, at least for cross laminated timber, is the modulus parallel to grain and the rolling shear modulus. So I'm going to define two probabilistic models for these two properties, and I'm going to see how the response, or how the displacement, the maximum displacement varies with these two models. And if we go to OpenTurns, that is always inside Salome, I can connect directly my fine element model with OpenTurns. I can have here, for example, an evaluation of the deterministic model. So this would be the classical analysis that we would do for code-based verification for serviceability limit state. We have a mean value of 11,600 megapascal for the modulus of elasticity parallel to grain, and 100 megapascal for the rolling shear modulus, and the response is 16.1 millimeters. Now I want to define a probabilistic model for these two parameters, so I need to enter a mean value and a coefficient of variation if I select a normal or a log normal distribution. Typically a log normal distribution would be desired for this kind of analysis. Of course, now you need to have this additional data, so it is always a challenge, but we have to have in mind that the first thing important is to have the tools to be able to do this kind of analysis. Then you have to be able to look for additional information and a way to extract this information. So I'm going, for example, to use a paper that we wrote a couple of years ago with some colleagues that was in some experimental response of cross laminated timber panels. And in this paper, we actually reporting the bending and the shear stiffness as we calculated from the tests from a mathematical model. We have 7 specimens. We'll take as a reference this panel that is similar to the one that we're using, and I can have a mean value, but I'm interested more in the coefficient of variation for the bending stiffness and for the shear stiffness. So here I'm going to simplify a little bit, and I can say that I consider a 10% coefficient variation for my modulus of elasticity parallel to grain, and a 40% for my rolling shear modulus. Having this information, I can go back to the model and I can input these two variabilities. So this means that I have my probabilistic model, and then I can go and perform a central tendency analysis and do a series of Monte Carlo simulations. So in this case, I'm doing more than 100 simulations. You can see in the plot matrix some results, summarized results. So based on these distributions, you are doing various analyses with various values. You can see, for example, that the rolling shear modulus is not very strongly correlated to the displacement in the middle, but the modulus of elasticity is strongly correlated. You can see here for each of the input parameters and the output, either the probability distribution function of this analysis or the cumulative distribution function, this is a fragility function. So these are the response of the input, and this is the response of the output. So this would be a probability distribution function, the cumulative or fragility analysis. So here, what in the end you can do with this? So you have a panel of 6 meters, so 6,000 millimeters. One limit could be that you define the length by 300, for example, and you have 20 millimeters to satisfy as a maximum limit. In this case, I have a response of 16 millimeters. So either I have to use a panel that is less stiff, would be more economic, and get closer to this limit. And in this case, I would always have a better, let's say, design. But in reality, you can also flip the coin and see that when you have this panel, for example, what is the probability of non-exceedance of the 20 millimeters? So if I put here 20 millimeters, I can see that from 97% I would be below this limit. If I was designing with a deterministic analysis that would be very close to 20 millimeters, I would be with a 50% probability of non-exceedance of this limit. So in the end, is also a way to be able to show that even if you do a more conservative design, you can actually show that what is the benefit of this design. Also, with this approach, you can also talk with the client, you can satisfy specific needs of the client, understanding with him what are the implications of everything that you design. So I think that all in all is something that we have the duty to promote, and to try to bring these probabilistic methods and probabilistic performance-based design always more in our designs. So for this reason, this is one of my motivations to do this video, and I think I will continue to do some videos presenting OpenTurns, because I think it has a very good potential for our profession. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I see you in the next one. Thank you.